We toured the largest heating and air manufacturing facility in the nation. Welcome to Daikin.
In this video, we are going to show you what's behind closed doors for most homeowners and show you things that have never been recorded before. Never. We're going to show you how this massive facility in small town America is changing the HVAC industry. And we will even show you some upcoming products that haven't been released to the market yet. Most of that will be in our new series that you can find in our YouTube playlist called Daikin Texas Technology Park Trip. But best of all, we are going to show you the real magic, which is the people making it all happen. People that are passionate and excited that Daikin has chosen to create American jobs that we're going to get to meet right here. So let's get started. How big is this place really?
It's big. It's huge.
How big is the Daikin factory? 74 football fields can fit inside the factory. And to prove that point, how big that is, I'm here at our local high school football field. I'm gonna run this thing 74 times to show you how big that is. Let's get started. I don't know what I was thinking. Out here running like I'm Mr. Beast or somebody making YouTube videos. I'm too chubby for this.
This place is so big that 11 US Navy super carriers would fit inside this building. 7 Empire State Buildings would fit under this roof. We drove almost a half a mile to get from one side of the building to the other. There are thousands of people that work here, thousands of American jobs. Over 20 languages are spoken in this factory on any given day.
So I've been with the company for 6 years, and I see all kind of different giant elephants, right? I never see anything like this.
Yeah.
We're talking about 15,000 people. We're talking about 4.2 million square feet of space. We're talking about probably a 15 different languages under this roof. So can you imagine that? You know, it's just a beauty. And you put all these cultural...
It's a big melting pot of Harris County, Waller.
And that's what, in my opinion, that's what, look at me. Did you see goosebumps? I got the goosebumps because that's what made this company special.
Now let's go to the brand new Daikin Fit product line. Believe it or not, this is the first time anyone has recorded this assembly line. It was important to Daikin to have this product assembled on an assembly line here in America. We will be doing more videos in the future with the people that work on the Daikin Fit assembly line. Some companies are first, some are best, some are just different. Daikin seems to be all three. We asked Marc Bellanger, Director of Marketing Communications, what's the big picture for Daikin? And he said this.
When you consider that 40 to 60%, right, of the energy used in buildings in North America are used actually by heating and cooling products, right? So we as a manufacturer, we feel that we really have a strong role to play in helping reducing the energy usage, which would help reducing CO2 emissions, mm-hmm. right? For us, when we see, you know, if we look ahead in our crystal ball and what we know of the market, mm-hmm. right, and we look at regulation, the regulation environment, consumer interests as well, towards more sustainable type products, but also better comfort system. Indoor air quality is a very strong component. IoT, connected devices, right? So it's all part of really the developments that the industry as a whole is going to.
Another cool thing we did while there was visit what Daikin calls the Dojo. The Dojo is Daikin's top-notch school behind the scenes, showing how they get the best in the industry at brazing, among other things. They go through intense training, which even includes global competitions, but more on that in a future video.
So what we have going on right now is part of our 5-day training that we have. So we conduct a 40-hour training, usually from Monday through Friday. So right now they're on their second day. What you see them going right now is over just some standard brazing techniques in order to ensure that, you know, we're training our employees to the best potential that they can have, you know. So right now we have three stations kind of set up. Right now they're still in the beginning stages, but the point is to get them to get a lot better by Friday.
Here we are in the Daikin factory. We're up on what they call the mezzanine, right above everything. And you can see, I mean, it's just so hard to tell the sheer, how big this place is. And this is just one side, so we can turn around. And you see it on this side too. So we've got some Goodman units being built down here. See them turned on, being tested, and then we go right across. Here's some Amana units being built. So all these units, Daikin, Goodman, and Amana, all being built right here in America, right here in Houston, Texas. Another cool thing is some of the community projects Daikin does. We can't fit them all into one video, but here's Chad for a few.
What you're seeing is one of our community projects.
Okay.
We go every year to Waller ISD, the elementary schools. Now there's 5 schools in Waller Elementary. We bring over the Earth Day topic.
Okay.
So we're kind of starting to promote in the younger generation being environmentally conscious. We want the kids to really start thinking about that as a young age. As Daikin, we're very aware globally as one of our environmental concerns.
Mm-hmm.
And we had the kids draw their depiction of what the theme is for that year. So every year it changes. A couple of years you'll see up here, one was plastic waste, one is animal conservation. And so different years, different pictures. And we go around, and of course, all the materials are supplied by us.
How old are these kids?
Fifth graders are about...
No way.
Yeah, these are fifth graders.
Wow.
So...
Way more talented than me.
If you see some of them on the walls, it is quite impressive.
What's the motivation for Daikin to want to do this?
Well...
Other than having awesome artwork on the wall.
Besides having free decorations,
yeah.
Right? No. We are always very involved in our community. This is a core value from all of our facilities. Where we manufacture, we don't just want to set up shop. This is one of many programs that we have in the community. You'll learn more about that when you go to the Dojo. They have one in place. We give scholarships. We go to the FFAs. I was in a parade one year, so it really is one of the more unique aspects, I believe, of what we do.
Finally, we wrapped up with some of the lead project managers, engineers, and team leaders covering some of the great product lines and even some upcoming products. Let's start with Jim Cahill, one of the folks behind Daikin's OneCloud services, which allows homeowners and contractors the ability to know when something's wrong with your HVAC system before there's a big problem.
20 years in the industry, I've been on the contractor side, I've been on the distributor side, I've worked for other manufacturers, and I've even done a startup, software startup in the industry. The simple fact of the matter is Daikin has gone from 0 to over $7 billion in sales in North America in the last 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
Globally, they are the leader of HVAC. They're the ones who innovated. They're the ones who created VRV, brought that to the market. They're the ones that, you know, when you look at our compressors, when you look at the technology that goes into that, for somebody in the industry, there is one clear leader, and that's this company.
Next, we talked to Connie Schroder, one of the leaders behind Daikin's ductless products.
Daikin, we are focused on HVAC equipment. It's 91% of our business. So other brands, they look at other different things, different home appliances, your fridge, your washer and dryer, your HVAC equipment. So that's a lot of things that you're working to do in someone's home. But Daikin, 91% of what our business model is air conditioning equipment. So I kind of talk about it as like the Chick-fil-A model, like pick one thing and do it well. And for Daikin, it's heat pump, inverter, refrigerant management technology, and we're doing that well. So you can trust that there's a lot of resources going into that system, and all of our focus is on that, and we're aligning ourselves up to be number one in North America. So it's a great company to be a part of, and
yeah,
have that equipment in your home.
Next, we talked to David Palazzolo, who was part of the launch of one of the industry's leading products, the Daikin Fit.
From an innovation standpoint, we always want to really showcase and highlight and give the Daikin contractors kind of a little bit of the leading edge, you know, folks like yourself. And so we always try to roll out product launches for the Daikin brand first.
We have videos launching soon that will have more in-depth interviews with everyone we've shown and some that we haven't shown. Our last clip comes from Jim Lowell, who is part of a lot of the Daikin controls used for their systems.
Daikin is, first of all, number one in the world. More Daikin systems installed and running around the world than any other manufacturer. So we are number one in the world. You don't get there unless you do some things right.
And oh,
Daikin does a lot of things very right. The ability to manage heat and humidity in your home, from the ability to manage airflow for optimum comfort, and as we've already discussed, to manage your energy usage, Daikin is the lead across the board.
We had such a great time visiting Daikin Texas Technology Park. The products and company are great, but the biggest thing I took away from this whole experience was seeing the pride many of the people have working for this company. I might be buying a great product and having pride on my end, but seeing firsthand, behind the scenes, the pride that a lot of these folks have was almost surreal.
So that's it, guys. Please hit that subscribe button. Wrapping up here at the Daikin Factory in Houston, Texas. We'll see you next time.